Hello and welcome to CS++. This is the video series where I am attempting to make computer science and related topics as accessible and approachable as possible. This episode is in the CS101 series. While you can watch any of the 101 videos in any order you would like to, I suggest that you watch all of the 101 videos before continuing on to the 201 series. Now, in this episode, I am going to talk about computability and the halting problem. Now, it is important to remember that I am trying to make these videos as accessible and high level as possible so that anyone can understand them. So with that in mind, we're not going to go into a whole lot of details about computability. Let's go with the Wikipedia definition here, which says computability is the ability to solve a problem in an effective manner. And this talks about the theory of computation within computer science, which is what brought us here, of course. Now, as I already said, I'm not going to go into the technical details here, but I want to mention the halting problem, because this is the crux of what I think you might be thinking right now. So you might be thinking, computers can basically do anything, so what is not computable? So to answer that question, I'm going to bring up a very classic problem. And this is called the halting problem. Now the idea is, in the general case, there's no way to know if a program will ever finish. This is the general case. So determining if a program will finish is considered to be a non-computable problem. That is the halting problem. This is stated as in the general case because if I have a program that says print hello, and that is the entirety of the program, then I have a pretty good idea that that program is going to complete. If, however, I have a program that says, while work to do, then do more work, I have no way of knowing if this program is ever going to complete. The only way to know if this program is going to complete is to try to execute it. So if I have something from the outside, some outside observer that is executing this program, and the outside observer says, yep, it printed hello, and then it exited. So I know the program completed. Now, this one, I try to observe it. I say, well, there's work to do, and I do work. And then I go back to while there's work to do, and then I do work, and then I go back, and then I do work. I would have to wait, perhaps, an infinite amount of time to know if this program is ever going to finish, because I have no idea if there's ever going to be an end to the work to do. So let's just say, as a hypothetical, I want to simulate the universe. I am never going to finish. We don't know when the universe, quote, ends, if ever. So I can constantly be running and producing work, again, in this loop here, and producing output without ever finishing. So again, the point that we're talking about here is the halting problem. And the halting problem says, in the general case, there is no way to know if a program will ever finish, or a computation. So the halting problem is a non-computable problem. There are other examples, but I thought that it would be most efficient and interesting in this video to talk about the things that are not computable as opposed to the things that are computable. Because again, this gets into lots of technical jargon here. All right, so that's going to wrap up this episode of CS++. I hope you learned something here. I thought it was important to mention this idea. We're not going to talk about Turing completeness and all this other things. All right, so for your homework, look up a Turing machine, T-U-R-I-N-G machine. And you will find lots of interesting information, probably other YouTube videos about that. So thank you again for watching this episode of CS++. Hope to see you in the next one.